Hello, I'm Danny Keefe with The Curious Cork, and today we're going to be talking about how to taste wine. That's so awesome, how to taste wine. There's three main things. One is to stop and slow down. Two is, what are we tasting? What are we actually picking up from this wine? And three is, be bold and free associate. So we're going to stop, slow down, and taste. That is so awesome. What did I get in that? I got graham crackers, I got cherry, I got raspberries, I got a little cocoa, I got a little chocolate, maybe even just a little bit of apple pie. Fantastic. But I got that because I stopped and slowed down. What does a taste remind you of? What are we tasting? What is it like when we're tasting on the front of our tongue versus the middle of our tongue versus the side of our tongue or the other side of our tongue? What do we get from that? Because we get different things from different parts of our tongue. So have fun with it. Think about it. What do we get? Now the third thing is to free associate and be bold. So you're drinking this wine and it tastes like grandma's pumpkin pie? That's awesome, because that's what it tastes like for you. So say, wow, that's grandma's pumpkin pie, and love it for that. Or maybe, man, that reminds me of barbecue on the 4th of July, a little steak or biscuit or chicken or whatever. Maybe that tastes like graham crackers or s'mores on an open fire. That's fantastic. Ooh, I get rosemary. No, grilled rosemary. Ooh, I get a little bit of citrus on that. It's all good because we're training our palates, we're enjoying it, we're learning how to taste wine, and we're free associating. And the pleasure of this whole experience quantifies immensely. So when we're drinking wine, it's a personal thing. Let's slow down. Let's enjoy the beauty of it. Let's associate. If it's grandma's pumpkin pie, then it's grandma's pumpkin pie. And all of this will make the whole experience of tasting wine even that much better. Now, I'm going to get back to this Baraki Pinot Noir.